Hi, I'm Dr. Bungie. We're here at the Bungie Chiropractic Clinic in Bluffton. Degenerative changes of the hip leads to inflammation, arthritis, and pain. What's one of the primary causes of this all too common scenario? Well, it's movement, or more specifically, lack of movement of that hip, and more specifically, the pelvis, which it connects to. When muscles tighten up, they impede movement. So the key to pain-free movement is opening up and gaining muscle control of our hip, our pelvis, and our low back. So let's get started.
Exercise number one is pelvic tilts. Lie on your back with your knees bent, feet pointing straight ahead, with your arms relaxed and out to your side and the palms facing up. Now you're going to simply roll your pelvis forward, arching your back and using your back muscles to perform this motion. Allow yourself to breathe in as your belly opens up and moves towards the ceiling. Now we're going to pelvic tilt backwards by rolling your back flat to the floor while contracting your abdominals and breathing out. You'll feel your belly button move towards the floor. The upper body and feet are not pushing in this motion, they're staying completely relaxed. The mid back and pelvis are doing the work. You can repeat this 10 to 20 times. Exercise number two is the seated leg roll. Sit on the floor with the legs straight out in front of you and your feet pointed up. Your legs are a little wider than your hip width apart. Your arms are externally rotated with the palms facing backwards and your shoulder blades brought slightly back. Roll your pelvis forward to put an arch in your back as you stand up to sit up tall. Keep your legs as tight as possible by contracting the muscles on top of your legs so that you keep your toes pointed up and your feet are slightly flexed. Now here you're going to roll your feet and your thighs in, and then you're going to roll them back out. Roll from the hips, not just the feet, so that your entire leg moves and not just the lower foot and the ankles. The seated leg roll can be done with 3 sets of 10 rolls. Exercise number 3 is the hip crossover. Now we're going to lie on the floor, our knees are bent so our feet are flat on the floor, and our arms are out at the shoulder level, palms down and fingers spread out as far as they could go. Now you're going to cross the right ankle over the left knee. Keep your upper body relaxed and the foot on the floor pointing straight ahead. You're going to rotate your body to the left so that the foot on the knee touches the floor and you feel a stretch in your right hip. If you're unable to reach the floor, place a small block or roll of towels under the foot and knee so you don't have to travel so far. Now look to your right and keep your upper body as relaxed as much as possible. Open your knee up by pushing with the gluteal muscles on the side of your hip where I'm pointing to. Hold for up to 1 minute. When you're finished, now you can bring your leg back and repeat on the opposite side.
If any of these movements create pain, stop immediately and seek professional guidance. I'm always here to answer any of your questions, and as always, I look forward to our next session.